In this Photoshop tutorial, we're going to combine two images and make it look like they belong together. And if you love Photoshop, hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, and you'll get a free tutorial from me each week. Now, the first thing you want to do is you want to look at the size of the image when you're combining the two. So go under Document Dimensions and take note of the size. This one's 5184. This one's 5870. So to avoid any resolution issues, you want to take the larger image and drop it on top of the smaller image. So that way we're only scaling down and we're never scaling anything up, because that softens the image and it loses quality. Let's choose the Move tool. And with the Move tool selected, we're going to drag and drop this into the other document. So just drag up. Now don't let go. Go into the tab. The second image you open. Move to the middle, don't let go yet. Now hold down the shift key and now let go. The reason we held down the shift key is it will center it. And if we look now, we've combined the two images into one. Obviously we want to cut out the line and match the color so it looks realistic. Make sure the move tool is selected and hit Ctrl T or Command T for free transform. Let's scale this down a little bit so it fits within our boundaries. So I'm dragging it down. Notice it's proportional. If it's not proportional when you drag it, hold the shift key and that will keep it there. And also if you hold down the Alt or the Option key, we can scale it from the middle. Great. So let's just drag this into the middle and hit Enter. Now we can see the whole image. Let's cut out our lion. So go under the Tools, and then we're going to choose either the Object or the Quick Selection tool, doesn't matter, because each of these will give us this option that says Select Subject. Click on Select Subject, and Photoshop's AI will make a selection for us. All right, now we want to fix the fur areas. So let's choose Select and Mask. And now we're in the Select and Mask workspace. What we want to do is use the Hair tool, which is the Refine brush, and then we're going to go around the edges here of the long hairs, and this will help us get a better selection. Great. Let's do the bottom. All right, a couple of other little settings that help with the selections. Under Radius, we're going to set this to 1. And then turn on Decontaminate Colors at the bottom. So let's go ahead and we're going to click OK. Great, we've got our lion. Let's resize it and position it now. Hit Ctrl T or Command T for free transform. And once again, let's scale this. And we can move it into position. Maybe here looks quite good. Let's hit the Enter key. Now what we need to do is blend these feet in so they look like they're actually in the grass. So we're going to make sure we're selecting our layer mask, not the layer, but the mask next to it. And we're going to grab a brush. With the brush, we're going to paint with black. Black will hide the layer. And by the way, these masks are a lot of fun to play with. So black will hide it, white will show it. And then with the brush, we're just going to brush around the feet so the line is sinking into the grass and not skirting across the top of it. There we go. Now what we need to do is match the color of the lion with the rest of the image, and then we're going to create a shadow to match the shadow here. So first thing, let's match the colors. With the lion layer selected, notice I'm not on the mask anymore, I'm now on the layer. Grab our move tool. And now what we're going to do is go under Image Adjustments, and then we're going to choose Match Color. So with Match Color, what we want to do is we want to match the color from our background to the color of our foreground. So notice here we've got different images open. Let's make sure we're working on this image. So if we go under Source, you'll see all the open tabs are here. We want to choose the same image, and then we want to match the layer. So the layer we want to match is called background. So there's the source, there's the layer, background. Notice immediately we'll take the color of the background. Now this is a little too strong, and that's what the fade slider is for. So if we look at fade, on the left is the new color. If we drag this all the way to the right, here is our original color. So what we want to do is find just the right blend between the two. So as we move it to the left, we bring in more of that new color. And we just need to find a nice match. and just find where it matches your eye. And then we're going to click OK, and the colors are matching better now. Why don't we add a nice shadow so it matches the windmill over here? So with our layer selected, we're going to go down to Effects, and we're going to choose a drop shadow. So with the drop shadow, what we're going to do is we're going to take our opacity to 100. Let's set our distance to 0. Size and spread, let's just put all that to 0. So this is going to create a solid black shadow. And if I drag, you can see that's the shadow it's going to create. And we're going to use this just as a little mask. So once again, set that distance to 0 and see how that matches it. Click OK. Now we want to separate the shadow out into a brand new layer. If we right click on effects and we go to create layer, now this will create a nice black layer and we can use this for our shadow. So select our shadow layer. And now we're going to go to free transform. Control or Command T for free transform. Right click and we are going to flip this vertical. Let's just drag it down. And you can see the shadows are starting to appear underneath the lion. Now, if you look at that shadow, see how it's kind of moving a little bit to the side? That's called skewing. Let's skew that. So we're going to right click and choose skew. And if we drag it, notice how we can skew that. So let's just copy the angle that we're seeing from the other shadow. And then we're just going to drag that up, line up the feet, click OK. It's not quite looking realistic yet. A couple more things to do. One is I'm going to apply a blur on the edge. So we're going to choose Filter, Blur, and we're going to soften this. We're going to use a Gaussian blur. Now, we could have created the blur when we created the original drop shadow with the size slider, but it's better to see it here on the image on screen using the Gaussian blur. Then we can just see what really matches our image better. So I'm going to take it to about 14.8, click OK. And now we're going to reduce our opacity. Let's take our opacity down so it kind of blends into the background a little bit better. Now there's other things we could do such as displacement maps and different things, but once again, I want to keep this simple because it's a beginner's tutorial. So let's just call that a shadow. And the last step is a little trick I came up with which works well when you're combining layers and you want to just tie everything together, and that's by applying a little bit of a color to it. Let's do that right now. So we're going to go under the adjustment layers and we're going to choose a solid color just to keep it simple. So with a solid color, we can choose any color we want. Let's get a kind of warm color tone here. Click OK. Now we're going to change the blend mode of this to color. So only the color is going to change and everything else is going to be intact. And now what we do is we want to blend this color in with the original color. So we're going to take the opacity all the way down. And then just bring it up a little bit and see as we start to apply some of that color now, notice how it really ties everything together. If you want to use a different color, click on the color here, just double click, and then we can change the color. And we can go through different colors. Look at this, see how it affects the image. And find the mood you're looking for. Click OK. So I wanted to just keep this one simple for beginners. There's a lot of different things I could have done, and I've created a lot of other tutorials that shows you how to do all those other things like displacement maps and more accurate color matching and different things like that. Let me know in the comments underneath if you found this tutorial useful. And maybe the next one you might want to look at is my layer masking for beginners, and that'll help you understand layer masks. I'll add a link to it. Do me a favor, hit that thumbs up, that's the like button, and don't forget to subscribe to Photoshop Cafe. Until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.